We set our eyes to Zion and judge our people right on.
Set Your Eyes to Zion has always been, I think, collectively, like the band's, like, one of our favorite tracks from our first major album on Atlantic Records back in the day. I think it was, what, 2000 or 98, 99. And that song, I think, encapsulates like the way P.O.D. interprets reggae music, you know, or the way we do reggae music, kind of, you know what I mean? Like, it's not a straight, like, you know, reggae type of track. Marcos's guitar playing is completely different than you hear, like, on a roots reggae band's track that does the skank, you know what I mean? He's doing riffs, and I'm not even doing like a one drop type of beat on it, you know what I mean? I'm just playing along with them, and the same with Trey. But at the same time, even though all those elements are broke for like being like a reggae type of song, it still comes out a reggae vibe, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And so for this song, this is one of them songs again that I feel selfish about, that I want, you know, the P.O.D. fan or the un-P.O.D. fan for the first time, or the new P.O.D. fan to hear. And that's why I was kind of like on the tracking list, I was like, why is this one last? Like, this needs to be up in the front. But I mean, I'm glad that it's anchor in the back. Like, it's like a nice lady, dude.
Just
you gotta
curious,
have a nice back.
Did
homie.
You did, just curious, Sonny.
Joking, homie.
Were you not as confident with that song? Because I kind of got that vibe off you. When
I didn't
we were tracking
think I didn't think it was gonna be as strong as it was, just because it was such an older song. That song's literally 15 years old. And back then, styles were different. Like, I was even I'm kind of almost borderline rapping it, right, rather than singing it. So it was different. So even back then, that Fundamental was one of the first times we were forced to kind of, not forced, but we decided, oh, dude, we're gonna put a little bit of melody, and, you know, it's a reggae song, let's have this kind of melody to it. Louis Dredd and I, we were in there, and I'm like, dude, I'm gonna give you, since a lot of the vocals overlap, I'm like, how about I do a section, you do a section. So it's almost like a duet. We're singing together, overlapping each other. We hit the harmonies together. We hit the bridge. The bridge is probably my favorite part vocally.
You know, but that, dude, just to throw it real quick, the bass and the drum rhythm on that cut is ridiculous.
Yeah, it's always been kind of,
it's like stupid.
And a beautiful thing about it too, man, is like we're all our own worst critics all the time. So it's funny when I hear him saying, ah, man, I just wasn't feeling it or whatever. And I can listen to him like, that's the freaking amazing.
That's the cut. Yeah,
what are you talking about?
I thought that way before I even put the vocals on. I was kind of afraid to do it, you know?
Yeah, but that's the nature of the beast. You know what I mean? That's, you know, that's how we are.
And I think that's why I'm glad it's on there, because it's like a really iconic P.O.D. song. But dude, you should tell them about the drum kit you played, because the drum kit you played on this album, because we decided to put drums last minute, and Wolf didn't have his kit, and we had this kit in the studio that was
I'm playing like the oldest drum. I don't even know what the heck it is, dude. It's like have you seen freaking Toy Story, that doll that has like the head like this and the other body and like all these different pieces on that make like one thing? That's like what this kit was. It was ridiculous.
And it sounds
drum smorgasbord.
If I was in a freaking studio with like a producer, they would be like, there's absolutely no way this is going to sound good. I'm like, dude, drums is the oldest acoustic instrument on the planet. All you have to do is just tune it up and hit the crap, dude, and it's gonna.
Yeah. And it sounds pretty good.
The studio that you just tune it up, you're fine. And to me, I think these drums sound freaking phenomenal, dude.
Yeah.
It's like old Rasta records.
In a real recording session, they need a whole week to tune the drums.
Yeah.
Get the right drum heads.
Drum Paradise is coming out. Yeah. We're spending $10,000 on drum tech.
$20,000 on techs for them to come in.
I think the heads on this drum have been changed in like 10 years.
Dude, 20.
Yeah.
Hey, the funny thing is, what we were like, you know what? This is how they get the sound on the Rasta records. This is it. You know, we were like so stoked.
They don't have money. They don't have money for real drums.
Rasta business, boy.
There we go.
They call that ragamuffin. My bread's been right.